So children, now we are coming for the modification of stem. And modification of stem, what type underground stem and for what kind storage of food. That means how do underground stem modify for the storage of food. As I told you, stem can be underground, but if it is underground, then also the nodes and internodes should be there. So you can see that example is potato and it comes under the category of stem tuber. Why do it is a stem? Because it bears nodes. The eyes of the potato are actually its node, and on the node always the scaly leaves is there, and in the axil of scaly leaves the axillary bud is there, which we cannot see because the potatoes which we are getting from the market are already rubbed and washed, so that the scaly leaves are removed, but the nodes are visible on those potatoes also. So how do potato is underground and how do it stores food? Actually, this is the plant of the potato and these are the underground branches. These are the roots also. You can label it as roots. These are the roots, but in amongst the roots also some of the underground branches are also there. So these underground branches, what do they do? Actually, the food prepared by these green leaves is stored underground, and that is stored in at the tip of these underground branches, so that this swollen structure is formed, and we call this swollen structure as potato, which comes under the category of stem tuber. Okay, again I am repeating, these green and leaves are photosynthetic. Whatever the food they will prepare, this food will be stored in these underground branches whose tips are swollen because of the storage of food, and we call it as stem tuber. Why do it is stem? Because it bears nodes and internodes. These are the gap between two nodes is internode, on which the scaly leaves, and in the axil of scaly leaves the axillary bud is there. Okay, and when there is a onset of favorable condition, if this potato is sown under the soil or it is divided into many parts, but in each part there should be a node, and in the node axil of the scaly leaves the axillary bud is there. This bud will get activated at the onset of favorable condition, and then further it can give rise this type of plant. So that way it also helps in vegetative propagation. You have done it in the 10th class also. This is one underground stem modification which is given in your book here only. This is stem. Now it is coming the rhizome. Rhizome also shown it here. This is very poor type of diagram I drawn in the book, but I have drawn it very systematically. So now here it comes rhizome, the second modification of underground stem, and its example is ginger. Here you can see I have drawn the ginger. Again, ginger also a very common, you know, ginger means adrak, which you have already seen at home also. So these are the lines like structure which are actually the nodes of the ginger. It is again a underground stem over which these are the scaly leaves, and in the axil of scaly leaves always the axillary bud. This is the identification of stem. These three things are, or three parts are also always should be there on the stem, whether it is under the ground or above the ground. Again the same process, if this part of a ginger is sown in the soil and there is a onset of favorable condition, so this axillary bud will get activated and then it will form the aerial branch. Whatever the food will be prepared by this aerial branch will be stored underground, so that it will produce more and more branches of underground stem, and that way it grows more and more horizontally below the soil. So that way this ginger is again a modification of underground stem for the storage of food. It grows horizontally. Now it comes the corm. Corm is also shown in your book. They have not written the categorization, not even in the theory part also, but I have divided it just by observing the pictures only. You are also to do the chapter from these notes only. Now we are here coming to the third modification of underground stem, that is corm. Corm example is colocasia. In Hindi it is called as अरबी सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट वेरी वेल. तो कोलोकेशिया आई हैव ड्रॉन इट हियर. इन दिस एंड इन दिस देयर इज वन डिफरेंस दैट राइजोम ग्रोज हॉरिजॉन्टली बट इट ग्रोज कॉर्म और कोलोकेशिया ग्रोज वर्टिकली. रेस्ट ऑफ द कैरेक्टर आर सेम. दीज आर द नोड्स ओवर द नोड्स. स्केली लीव्स आर देयर इन द एक्सिल ऑफ स्केली लीव्स. Always there is a axillary bud and it is again a example of underground stem for the storage of food. Then it comes the bulb. Bulb example is onion or turmeric. In bulb, whatever the part of the onion you eat, actually it is a underground fleshy leaves. Jo hum khate hain pyaaj mein, that is a fleshy underground leaves. But where do the stem? Stem is actually here. This discoid portion is there and this is underground reduced stem is there and this is the root. Okay. So that way you can divide the part of the onion. This is root, this is stem and this is leaf. But these are underground fleshy leaves over which the green leaves are also there. You may have seen the green onion also when the season of green onion is there. So whatever the food prepared by these green leaves above the ground, that food prepared by these leaves is stored in these underground leaves. And this part becomes eatable because the food is stored here. Here the stem is not fleshy, but it is underground and hence it has come in this category of underground stem. But in this the food is not stored in this underground stem. In rest of the underground stem, the food is stored, but in the bulb, the food is not stored. In the bulb, the food is stored in the underground fleshy leaves. That way here the underground stem modification is completed. Next modification we will see in the next video.